So my research these days is focused on additive manufacturing, and in particular the 3D printing of metals. Although the basic machines for 3D printing that work with polymers have been around for quite a while, we now have these machines that can print with metals. And so it's now possible to print parts like this, which are complex metallic parts that really work. Something that's particularly satisfying about the 3D metal printing research and activity is the opportunity to use advanced characterization techniques, such as the high energy X-rays from the synchrotron, to solve problems and challenges that are of immediate interest to industry, as well as addressing basic research questions that train students. The reason that we are so interested in this advanced characterization technique, which, by the way, very few places know how to do, is that one of the things you have to be concerned about when you print a metal part and then you use it is that many parts get subjected to cyclic loading. So they're subjected to loads that vary, that fluctuate. And these fluctuating loads seek out the weakest points in the material. So one of the things that we're finding is that these 3D pictures allow a much more complete understanding. And what it does for us is it shows us the bubbles inside the metal powder particles. And it's turning out that those bubbles inside the particles survive, or they carry through to the 3D printed metals. So another thing that happens when you print metals is that what you're doing is you're coming along with your laser beam or your electron beam, and you're rastering back and forth on top of the material that you're building, the powders, and you're causing the metal to melt, and everywhere that it melts and then refreezes, then it's pulling in, and that gives rise to something that we call residual stress. Now, another huge advantage of having access to this machine called a synchrotron is that you can do diffraction experiments. With the diffraction experiments, what you're doing is you're bouncing the X-rays off the atomic planes in the material, and so you are measuring the spacing between those planes. And if that spacing varies or is different from the spacing that's recorded in the books, then you know that you have some residual stress. However, one of the most fascinating aspects of this process, this technology, is that you get different microstructures and you get different opportunities to control those microstructures and therefore the properties. So what we are doing in various different projects is varying the microstructure by varying the composition and exploiting, taking advantage of this novel process. And an important part of that variation in composition is to understand things like residual stress, as well as the porosity, as well as the material strength, as well as its fatigue resistance. So all of these things come together in a very satisfying way to apply these basic research tools to very technological and near-term needs that exist in the industry.